Hi everybody. I hope you are doing super well today. In today's video, I'm going to speak about a very important topic, the conjugation of verbs ending with er in present tense. But first of all, did you know that more than 80% of verbs end by er in French? So, we are going to start with the subject personal pronouns, and if you might wonder what is the French translation. It's written in white below, and we pronounce it.
Les pronoms personnels sujet.
Just for you to know, everything that is written in orange is in English and everything in white is written in French. First thing first, what we can notice is that there is difference between English and French, because I wrote the pronoun, you, twice. This is because there is one for singular, and the other for plural. So now, let's see how to write all the different subject personal pronouns. The first column is for singular and as you can see, I is said.
Je.
As I said before, there is two you in French, and the first and singular one is translated by.
Tu.
The masculine third subject personal pronouns, he in English is.
Il.
She is translated by.
Elle.
I'm not going to speak a lot about the subject personal pronouns, it, in this video, because I will make dedicated videos that deals about this pronoun, and other aspects, but just for you to know, there are several translation which are.
Cela, ça, c'est apostrophe.
Now, we are going to move on to the plural subject personal pronouns, and we start by we, which is.
Nous.
You is translated by.
Vous.
In plural, and you can see that it's totally different from the singular pronouns, so don't miss this out. Also, there are two translations of they, depending on, if we are speaking about masculine plural, or feminine plural, so if you are speaking about a group of men, or a group of people with at least one man, you have to use.
Il.
And if you are speaking about a group of women, you need to say.
Elle.
Don't worry, I will also explain this grammar rule in a dedicated video. But for today, the main point is to teach you how to conjugate verbs ending by er, and this is what we are going to do right now. So, how to conjugate a verb ending with er? There are two steps to understand in order to conjugate a verb, and the first one is to find the radical of the verb. Here, we can see an example with the verb speak, in English. What we do in order to find the radical is that we remove the termination, er, of the verb. After that, the step two is to add the right termination. What you need to know, is that there is a specific termination for each subject personal pronoun. So, for the first person singular, the termination is. For the second person singular, the termination is. As you can hear it, we don't pronounce the s. For the third person singular, the termination is the same than the first person singular, so. For the first person plural, the termination is. For the second person plural, the termination is.
E.
And for the last person plural, the termination is.
E.
Also, for this termination, you can hear that we don't pronounce the two last letters. It's strange at the beginning, but you will get used to it. So, you need to memorize them in order to conjugate verb ending with er, in present tense. If you want to, you can pause the video to read them several times, before we move on to a concrete example. Alright, so here is an example with the verb speak that we have seen before. So, we are going to start with the first person singular. So, we write the first subject personal pronoun which is.
Je.
And after, the radical of the verb which is.
Parle.
And we add the termination of the first person singular which is e, so we obtain.
Je parle.
If the pronunciation is hard for you at the moment, don't worry, there will be phonetics videos in my channel. So we follow the same process for the second person singular, and we obtain.
Tu parles.
If you want to try to find the next ones, you can pause the video and write in a comment below what you think is the right answer. Alright, so the right answer is.
Il parle. Elle parle.
Depending if you speak about a man or a woman. The first person plural is.
Nous parlons.
The second person plural is.
Vous parlez.
The last person plural is.
Il parle.
When you speak about a group with at least a man, otherwise you say.
Elle parle.
So, now you are going to see another example with the verb love.
Aimer.
There is one specificity with the first person singular, because the subject personal pronoun is written.
J' apostrophe.
And the reason for this, is because the verb love in French starts with, a vowel. So the conjugation of this verb is.
J'aime. Tu aimes. Il, elle aime. Nous aimons. Vous aimez. Il, elle aime.
So the termination are exactly the same, the conjugation as well. The only difference is the
j' apostrophe.
And as I said before, it's because the verb starts with a vowel, and it's the same with all the vowels, but also if it starts with the consonant, h, you need to use it as a first subject personal pronoun. About all the other pronouns, they remain the same, 100% of the time. So now, we are going to conjugate two new verbs ending with er, in present tense, the verb to live, and the verb to deliver. Again, if you want to, you can write a comment below with the conjugation of those two verbs from first person singular to last person plural. If so, pause the video, and I will show you right after the answer. So let's start with the verb to live. So as you can see, we use the contracted pronoun as a pronoun, because as mentioned right before, when the verb starts with an H, we need to use it. Therefore, we say.
J'habite. Tu habites. Il, elle habite. Nous habitons. Vous habitez? Il, elle habite.
And about, the verb to deliver, the conjugation in present tense is.
Je livre. Tu livres. Il, elle livre. Nous livrons. Vous livrez. Il, elle livre.
Now, let's conjugate two other verbs, before we move on to the exercises. Therefore, I want you to conjugate the verb, to look or watch, and the verb, to guess. By the way, as you can see there is only one verb that is traduced by to look or to watch in French. We have no distinction like in English between them. Once more, if you want to, you can write a comment below with your answer. Don't worry, if you write three or more comments per video. It's not a problem at all. So, here is the answer. As you can see, both verbs don't start by a vowel or an H, so we use the normal pronoun, and for the verb to look or watch, the conjugation is.
Je regarde. Tu regardes. Il, elle regarde. Nous regardons. Vous regardez. Il, elle regarde.
And for the verb to guess, the conjugation is.
Je devine. Tu devines. Il, elle devine. Nous devinons. Vous devinez. Il, elle devine.
All right, I hope with all the example I gave you, you memorized how to conjugate verbs in present tense, and we are going to figure this out in another way with the exercises I prepared for you. So, in this exercise, I want you to choose which proposition on left matches with a proposition on right. So, we are going to start with the first one.
Je.
I let you a couple of seconds to think about it. For this one, there are two right answers, because the first and third person singular are the same in present tense in French. So I choose.
Je parle avec toi.
I speak with you. Again, I let you a bit of time to think of the second one. For this second sentence, it's the second pronoun, the singular you in French, and it matches with.
Aime les pommes de terre.
Because the second person singular ends with S, in French in present tense.
Tu aimes les pommes de terre.
You love potatoes. What do you think will match the next one?
Il mange de la viande.
He eats meat. As I said before, we could have chosen the first sentence in right, because first and third person singular are the same. Now let's move on to the first person plural.
Nous regardons la télévision.
We watch TV. As we have seen, the first person plural ends with ons. Just two remaining, according to your memory, how do you conjugate the next sentence?
Vous devinez ce qu'il va se passer?
You guess what is going to happen. And the latest one, because there is only one option remaining.
Elles habitent à la même adresse.
They live at the same address. In the sentence, what we can understand is that a group of women, exclusively, lives at the same address. So now we arrive to the last part of the video, the revision section. Let's start with a lovely verb, the verb to love. In French, we say it.
Aimer.
To speak is traduced.
Parler.
To live is traduced.
Habiter.
Don't forget the H at the beginning, even if we don't pronounce it. If you remember, to watch and to look has the same translation in French, which is
regarder.
Can you guess how to say guess in French?
Deviner.
And the last one, to eat.
Manger.
All right. So, it's the end of this video. I hope you enjoyed it. And if it's the case, you can press the like button, subscribe to receive notifications when I post new videos, and also share this video with people interested in learning French. Thank you for watching. See you soon.